I took a ferry from Rosseville to Inishmaan and was nearly lost to a watery grave. At first, I assumed the roughness of the waters was ordinary. The crew members seated around me were unbothered, looking at their phones, and I thought, okay, if they're not concerned, neither should I be. Then, after a few more minutes of galumphing and careening, I look over to see that the phones have been put down and the gaze has shifted to the portholes, so I made peace with my maker in my heart and rehearsed my action plan based on the movie portrayal of the sinking of the Titanic in my mind. By some random disclosure of grace, we made it safely to port, and as I descended the gangplank, my Airbnb host, a beautiful Irish grandpa, met me with cries of, "You're a brave woman for getting on that ferry today," and I felt very much like a new young schoolteacher from 1910, arrived fresh and full of gumption from the women's college to teach the island children arithmetic. As I rounded this corner, I met with another beautiful white-bearded farmer staring out to sea, and we chatted about America and how he had gone over there to make his fortune as an exclusively Irish-speaking youth. I went on my way and stopped briefly to read my book, lay in the long grass, and munch a succulent fruit.
And I love her so, I wouldn't trade her for gold.
Maybe she's born with it.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
I've been sitting here for less than an hour, and the isolation has already gotten to me. I've just been speaking to myself in an Irish accent. I think I've accidentally entered the underworld.
An Airbnb tour, starting with the door frame compared to my height. Island. Oh no. I thought that was rain. The window's just frosted over, which is good, so people can't see my business. And then, lovely hodgepodge kitchen, cozy fire stoked for me upon my arrival. And this is my baggage. This was not left here by someone else. Washing machine. Various items that I can cook with, which is good because you never want to buy things that you don't need to buy. This quaintness, this lovely cozy couch. There's no clear theme, which is perfect. I love it. A lovely garland, some lovely mugs, a lovely iron. And then, so we have, this is a loft. As you can see, these beds are not in use, but how cute is that? Now, there we go. In here, we have, and I still don't know where the light switch is for this room, the master suite. And behind this ancient door with a hanger on it, the master bath, the picture when I booked the Airbnb, hello, did not show any of the beds, but I assumed that there were some and I was correct. So sometimes you just gotta take a leap of faith. Now this is where, brethren, this is the second loft, also not in use, also just full of empty mattresses, because why would you make all the beds when there's only one person staying here? Hang on. So first of all, we have a very steep ascent. Then this weird tunnel, and you finally make it in. I love it so much.
I'm walking on moonbeams and staring out to sea.
Not pictured, me fully stopping, asking myself if not being able to light the fire was a good reason to cry, answering myself that it was not, then bossing up and continuing to fail, but with a stouter heart and firmer purpose.
If a door be closed, and a row of homes start building, and tear your curtains down, for sunlight is like gold.
When I think back on cresting that desolate plain and standing alone on that black sand beach, I am filled with the best and most special of secret emotions, TM. Also, long windswept grass is the absolute comfiest mattress. Here you see me in a state of deep and secure peace.
The simple feminine urge to walk directly into this.
And you better be you. Do what you can do. You're walking on moonbeams and staring out to sea.
This is the best day of my life. This, okay. Some fossil. There's that. This.
Not pictured, me, stuck on the backside of the island at dusk, deciding it is a good idea to cut across miles of stone animal pens, climbing over and knocking off pieces of ancient rock walls and invading the territory of many confused goats and cows.
As if your skin was soil. How long do you think before they start digging? If your life was gold, how long?